my great grandfather was a shaman in the north, and I was aware of that. I had there was a photograph I had of him, and he was wearing this coat, and it's a very kind of distinctive looking sealskin and caribou jacket, and it's got handprints on the chest, and then there's an Inuksuk in the middle of on the pendant. So when I visited the Winnipeg Art Gallery, I walked in, and in right away in their Inuit art section, on this pedestal, beautifully lit, was this coat, and it was called the Shaman's Coat, and it was the one that belonged to my great-great-grandfather, and I was just so curious about how it ended up there, and it turns out it's actually a replica, and I think it was a family member that made the replica. I was really curious about how it got there, but then also how we think about what is art, and this kind of this jacket that belonged to my great-grandfather is like a piece of art that belongs in a museum, and also just like why they have it versus why family doesn't have it. But it's and when I was there, the WAG was very, and always has been, open to me asking those questions. And the other thing that in the past few years the Winnipeg Art Gallery has done that I think is really fantastic is that they've hired full-time Inuit curators. And I think that's really important when, you know, they've housed the largest collection of Inuit art in the world. And that's because there's no place to house it in the Arctic. And until there's a place that actually can hold these pieces of artwork in Nunavut, basically they're on loan to the WAG and the National Gallery. And so for the WAG to hire Inuit curators, I think is really fantastic, because it just recognizes that when you're putting together an Inuit art exhibit, if it's not curated by Inuit, then it's not really an Inuit art exhibit.